Jesus said, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." Good morning.
Good morning.
Our service this morning begins on page 355 in the Book of Common Prayer. Also, you can find it in your service bulletin. Today, we celebrate the first Sunday of our Advent season. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be His kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Saying together, glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, give us grace to cast away the works of darkness and put on the armor of light. Now in the time of this mortal life in which your Son, Jesus Christ, came to visit us in great humility, then in the last day, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge both the living and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal. Through him who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated for our scripture reading.
A reading from the book of Jeremiah. These days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will fulfill the promise I made to the house of Israel and the house of Judah. In those days and at that time, I will cause a righteous branch to spring up for David, and he shall execute justice and righteousness in the land. In those days, Judah will be saved, and Jerusalem will live in safety. And this is the name by which it will be called. The Lord is our righteousness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us now read in unison our psalm appointed for today, Psalm 25, which you will find in your bulletin insert. Together.
To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. My God, I put my trust in you. Let me not be humiliated, nor let my enemies triumph over me. Let none who look to you be put to shame. Let the treacherous be disappointed in their schemes. Show me your ways, O Lord, and teach me your paths. Lead me in your truth and teach me, for you are the God of my salvation. In you have I trusted all the day long. Remember, O Lord, your compassion and love, for they are everlasting. Remember not the sins of my youth and my transgressions. Remember me according to your love and for the sake of your goodness, O Lord. Gracious and upright is the Lord. Therefore, he teaches sinners his way. He guides the humble
our God because of you. Night and day we pray most earnestly that we may see you face to face and restore what is lacking in your faith. Now may our God and Father himself and our Lord Jesus direct our way to you. And may the Lord make you increase and abound in love for one another and for all, just as we abound in love for you. And may he so strengthen your hearts in holiness that you may be blameless before our God and Father at the coming of our Lord Jesus with all the saints. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We stand for the reading of the gospel. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus said, "There will be signs in the sun, the moon, and the stars. And on the earth, distress among nations, confused by the roaring of the sea and the waves. People will faint from fear and foreboding of what is coming upon the world, for the powers of the heavens will be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. Now when these things begin to take place, stand up and raise your heads, because your redemption is drawing near." Then he told them a parable. "Look at the fig tree and all the trees. As soon as they sprout leaves, you can see for yourselves and know that summer is already near. So also, when you see these things taking place, you know that the kingdom of God is near. Truly, I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. Be on guard so that your hearts are not weighted down with dissipation and drunkenness and the worries of this life, and that day catch you unexpectedly like a trap. For it will come upon all who live on the face of the whole earth. Be alert at all times, praying that you may have the strength to escape all these things that will take place and to stand before the Son of Man. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Breakfast with God. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Please be seated. Well, Merry Advent. Today is the first Sunday of our new Advent year, year C, according to the traditional and ancient liturgical church calendar. So Happy New Year, church. Happy New Year, St. Philip, for our new liturgical year. The first Sunday of Advent marks the beginning of the Christian journey that prepares us and leads us into the Christmas season. But wait. Didn't I see Christmas candy and decorations on the opposite side of the Halloween candy and the Halloween decorations back in October? Well, I could go on and on about how our culture, and especially Wall Street, and an increasingly secular society have allowed commercialism to overshadow the Christian calendar and to dictate the beginning of the Christmas season and how it shall be celebrated. I still believe in principle that the church, not our culture, should be our guide into liturgical living. I've given up, of course, on the crusade, of changing the world by going back to a more liturgically correct Advent and then Christmas. But as a priest of the church, I still call upon Christians and this community to continue to encourage the Christian church, particularly those churches that come from liturgical and sacramental traditions, to keep the Advent season, to at least keep the Advent season, so that it might continue to enrich our lives during the Christmas season. In our gospel reading today, we find a central message of Advent. Be ready. Stand up and raise your heads, the gospel says. Be on guard and be alert at all times. The word Advent is really a Latin word that literally means to come or come forward. The word Advent is not just a churchy word that refers to the four Sundays of Advent that lead up to Christmas. The word Advent refers to the action and the powerful act of coming, coming into focus, coming into sight, coming into full view. It's a very action word. The word come actually occurs 1,400 times in the Bible. Did you know that? It refers to God's coming to us. It also refers to our coming to God. Like in the Advent season, the act of coming, coming into view, coming into focus, coming to the sight, suggests a certain sense of anticipation, a certain sense of anticipatory tension. It is this tension that is felt between the now, the present, and the not yet. The now of Advent and the not yet of Christmas. The now, the present time, and the not yet of the end time. You know, when I was a little boy, I couldn't wait to go to the Christmas parade, which was held every year downtown on Main Street. Many of you may still remember that. Mom and Dad would take us by the hand and lead us to a particular curbside where we could see the parade floats. We could hear the loud music, and we could see all the colorful Christmas characters. Oh, there were giant snowmen. There were Disney characters dressed in Christmas outfits, and a varied assortment of elves and gnomes, a cast of Santa's helpers, and a bunch of big men in small cars wearing funny hats darting in and out of the floats, which I didn't have a clue back then who they were. The floats looked like, really, like little villages passing by one. Our place on the curb was always positioned where we could look down the street and watch the parade make a turn on the street before it moved in front of us. So we could get a glimpse of each new float as it turned the corner one by one. It was all terribly exciting. But the one float that I watched for and anticipated the most was the float that Santa Claus was on. Every float and every act was really sort of winding the tension up for the first glimpse of Santa Claus. From the time the Santa Claus float first came into view, there was this immeasurable sense of anticipation and even tension as he finally turned that corner and came into view, as he came more into focus. Such are like the kingdom of God. The key message of this gospel reading is that we are to be ready. We are to be prepared, alert, not only for the arrival of the Christ child, the Messiah, the incarnation of God, but also for the return of Christ, the second coming of Christ, as Christ the King and Judge in the end time, which, by the way, is the second theme of Advent, not just anticipation to the Christ child, but the second theme of Advent is the coming, the second coming, the end time. To anticipate the birth of Christ is to anticipate the second coming, where all creation will be complete. In the Old Testament, God's people were told to be watchmen for the coming of the Messiah. And in the New Testament, God's people are told to be watchmen for the second coming of Christ. The Advent message warns us not to be so busy with the things in the here and now, including this prolonged Christmas season, that we fail to be faithful watchmen for the coming of Christ. As Christians, we are to live in a sense of readiness, to live in a sense of positive tension and anticipation, to live a life where we are ready and prepared to meet Christ. The Christ child and the Christ of the end time. You know, it's kind of like a fireman that just lives in a certain tension of being ready, of being prepared, and then suddenly being called. It's like a sub on a football team that is alert and ready and prepared to be suddenly called up to go on the field. It may be like an understudy, which I have been in this position before, like being an understudy that's ready and prepared while living in the positive tension of maybe suddenly being called. Or like new parents, preparing and waiting in joyful tension for the birth of their child. So are we also called to be alert, to be ready, to be prepared, to live in the anticipation and in the tension of the possibility of suddenly meeting Christ. Now, you know, only God knows the hour. But we are to live today as if we were going to meet Christ tomorrow. We are to be ready, to be prepared today as if we were going to have breakfast with Jesus tomorrow at 8:30 a.m. Are you prepared to have breakfast with God? Are you ready, alert, and prepared to be suddenly called to meet Christ? Might we embarrass ourselves or Jesus by not being awake, by not being alert, by being caught off guard? Or how we are currently living our lives. How do we prepare ourselves to be suddenly called to have breakfast with God? Well, for a start, we might want to check ourselves on how well we're doing with the great two commandments. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind and strength, and love thy neighbor as thyself. Are you ready to have breakfast with God tomorrow morning? Or are we more interested in having breakfast at Tiffany's than preparing ourselves with God? Now, mind you, that's one of my favorite movies. But I think the point is, are we more ready to have breakfast with the world, with our culture, than being prepared to have breakfast with our Maker, our Creator, and our Shepherd? I pray that we will be so prepared. Amen.
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 Let us now stand and say together the Nicene Creed. The Nicene Creed can be found on page 358 and also in your service bulletin. Together,
we believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally God from the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made.
prayers of the people are Form 3, and you will find it inside your service bulletin or on page 387 in the Book of Common Prayer. Let us pray. Father, we pray for your holy Catholic Church.
That we all may be one.
Grant that every member of the church may truly and humbly serve you.
That your name may be glorified by all people.
Remembering especially Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, Pope Francis of the Roman Church, Michael, our presiding bishop, the bishops and ministers of the Episcopal Church in the Anglican community, Phoebe, our bishop, and Father Terry, our priest. We pray for all bishops, priests, and deacons.
That they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
Remembering especially Joe, our president, Bill, our governor, and all mayors of Shelby County and the surrounding areas, we pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will in your give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake.
That our words may find favor in your sight.
Remembering especially Dwayne, Kathy, Sandra, Terry, Father Colenso, Brandon, Sam, Kathleen, Jason, and Phyllis. Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest, especially Right Reverend Bill Sanders and Francis Russell.
Let the light perpetual shine upon them.
We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in your heavenly kingdom.
In the diocesan cycle of prayer, we pray for the bishop and council. We pray for the West Tennessee Haiti Partnership Mission. We pray for the Village Mission in Liberia, Africa. We pray for peace of Jerusalem. We pray for peace among all nations. We pray for peace for our own nation. We pray for the protection and comfort of all those who serve this country in foreign and domestic lands, especially Trevor Holly and Jacob Stevens. We pray for Christians that are being persecuted throughout the world. The altar flowers are given to the glory of God in thanksgiving for our St. Philip family. Let us pray for all members of our parish family celebrating a birthday, especially Leo Bishop, Herky Hill, Steve Glenn, Martha Wilburn, and Kathy Howell. Let us pray for all members of our parish family celebrating an anniversary this week, especially James and Polly Pitcock, and Mike and Tina Stevens. Let us pray for our own needs and those of others.
We pray for travel mercies for all of those returning from the Thanksgiving holidays. We give thanks for all the blessings in this life. We especially give thanks this season for family and friends. O Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls. And to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
Let us now confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Our confession can be found on page 360 in the Book of Common Prayer and also in your service bulletin. Together,
most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy upon you. Forgive you all of your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you into eternal life.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Peace, everyone. Peace. 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 God's peace. Thank you. Peace. Thank you. Peace. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
This is the day that the Lord has made.
Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Oh, we do rejoice. We rejoice for now the beginning of our Advent season. Like the ending of our Pentecost season, our gingo tree has now ended its glory. Last Sunday it was in its glory. And it symbolizes, I so love that tree, it symbolizes the seasons of our lives and of the Christian calendar as well. Have a couple of announcements. This Wednesday we will resume our healing service at 12:10. Please come and be with us as we pray for others and also our own petitions. Our Christian education series based on the book The Grinch That Stole Christmas began today. So much fun and very profound from this children's story. We're going to enjoy the next 4 weeks. Come and join us. We do have extra books, but even if you just wanted to set in, it will be, I think, very rewarding for you, as it was for us this morning. A reminder about our prescription bottle ministry. We want to keep that filled up. And also our fall project for the Manna House, continuing to collect warm clothing, hats and coats and gloves, scarves, and also sleeping bags and blankets are needed as well. A food bank. This is the season where the food bank is always in need, so let's continue to feed that ministry. I'm so proud of all of our outreach ministries that we have and that we're able to be more active in them. The Emmanuel Center, we usually have Operation Joy. That's changed this year, but we are providing for some volunteers. We're providing Christmas cheer gifts for them. So if you will also give, make your checks out to Operation Joy, we're going to do our shopping for those young men and women who are teenagers, actually, helping the school out in their after-school program. Frankly, I think that those teenage volunteers and supervisors are probably as important as the students themselves. The poinsettia sign up is out. If you wish to dedicate a poinsettia to someone that you would like to honor or in memory of a loved one, please sign up on the bulletin board so that our Christmas altar will be adorned with that beauty. Our new Daily Bread meditation books are out, covering the months of December, January, and February. So December's right around the corner. Pick up your next copy of the Daily Bread so we can share that meditation together as a congregation. Are there any other announcements that we might need to make? Okay. Do we have any birthday celebrations? Birthday celebrations today? Anniversary celebrations? Well, we do have a special message from Donna Turner, who's going to share with us a little bit about our stewardship campaign. Please come up. Yeah, you can just come here. And you can come. Yeah, just.
Let me swap places with you.
Somebody I think she just goes.
Oh, I think I can stand here. Yeah. This will be the special thing. Well, hi, everybody. I'm Donna Turner, and for 27 years, it has been my privilege to be with the children of St. Philip in the Catechesis of the Good Shepherd, and in our community as well, too. And in through the presentations with them, through the materials, it has been something that I've grown in my understanding of this covenant relationship between God and us as one of gift and response. And when we think about God and the way He lavishes gifts on us, we could think of this intensification, kind of, because even the mineral world and the plant world, the animal world, human beings, and then in Jesus and His Eucharistic presence in the world with us today. And to this we ask, well, how do we respond to this? And so we can think of it in a multi-layered way, and through that first layer of response comes in just being attentive to God in our everyday life, like noticing that ginkgo tree back behind us, or seeing God within our family and friends.
Yes.
And then the second layer of response in this would be that of praying to say thank you to God, and also studying the Bible, the adult Sunday school, and when the children come for Catechesis of the Good Shepherd. Those are all ways that another intensification of response. And then we could say that at the pinnacle of this response would be to receive the Eucharist on that. And so we're here, we receive the Holy Eucharist. And so that is, we could say, that most intense moment of that covenant relationship with God. And I wanted to share with you, this is a prayer written by a child, and somehow I had it in his own handwriting, but between the 8 a.m. service and catechesis and now coming here, I've lost his handwritten copy, but I've got the prayer for you. And this is written by a 12-year-old boy named Chris, not from St. Philip, but from another group I do Catechesis of the Good Shepherd with. But I think his words, his prayer will help us as we ponder before us our own stewardship campaign and what that means. And Chris wrote, "The Lord has put himself in his creation. I can see him everywhere. The trees and the early morning wind are filled with him. The birds who sing for us all night and all day, they too are filled with him. God has set his creation in place and let it fend for himself, but he will never abandon us. He is always in and around us until the end of time. And then he wrote at the bottom, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Mm-hmm. Psalm 100.
Amen.
And so, as you think about how do we share fully, how do we love fully, share faithfully, may his words usher us into our response to our campaign. So, thank you.
Amen. There it is, found.
And it was found. The lost coin.
Oh, sticky fingers, Betty picked it up. No. Thank you, Donna, for that sharing. And boy, you can see that Donna's a gifted teacher. I told the 8 o'clock that I'm going to try to attend the Catechesis of the Good Shepherd. Thank you for that. And thank you again for Shannon Mullins for being our coordinator for this year's campaign. If you haven't had a chance, don't miss this. In our newsletter last Thursday, actually I think we published it on Wednesday, there is a YouTube video of Betty Albert sharing a very touching and heartfelt message from her heart about this campaign and what this church means to her. So please do, it's very easy. You just click on the picture, anywhere on the picture, and it comes up. So take your time to listen to that as well. Remember the words of our Lord Jesus, it is more blessed to give and to give of yourselves than to receive.
Thank you.
things come of thee, O Lord, and of thy own have we given thee. Amen. Create in me a clean heart, renew a right spirit within me, O Lord my God. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, because you sent your beloved Son to redeem us from sin and death and to make us heirs in him of everlasting life, that when he shall come again in power and great triumph to judge the world, we may without shame or fear rejoice to behold his appearing. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever say this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love, you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and became subject to evil and death, you, in your mercy, sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the hard wood of the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ is died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace, and at the last day bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Alleluia! Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia!
O Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world.
Grant us thy peace.
The gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep me in the everlasting life.
not be here today, and for all of those that we have prayed for, the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, keep them into eternal life.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
A special thanks to Bob Ely and Jeff Albert for providing us this very special, wonderful Advent music today.
Thank you.
It was so really beautiful. Thank you for your sharing your gifts with us. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May he shine his face upon you and be gracious to you. May he turn his countenance upon you and bring you peace. And may the blessings of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you for the rest of this Sabbath day, during your upcoming week, now during our great Advent season, and forevermore. Amen.